Hello everyone, welcome back to the workshop. Today I'm going to be building up a kit that modelroundup.com sent over, the limited edition 1/24th scale Porsche 917 KH LeMans winner from 1970. It's in 1/24th scale, it's from Revell, Germany, and it has 119 parts, builds up to 17.6 centimeters long. It is a beautiful kit, should be relatively easy to work on, but we'll see. I didn't see anything when I was pulling the parts out of the box that looked too complicated. What's nice to know is that these decals here are included, so there will not have to be any super fancy masking or painting up. Let's take a look at those 119 parts. First up will be the tree that has the tires on it. We got some poly caps here. These will help the tires slide onto their axles. Beautiful big and littles front and rear. We got a nice tread pattern on those tires. There is no name on the sidewalls, but we'll be able to cure that in a moment. We've got a chrome tree with various light buckets and small parts on there. I don't know if this is used in other kits. It seems like it's kind of quite a few on here, but we can see like some body fasteners and other things on there as well. We've got a good-sized clear parts tree where we've got our headlight lenses. We've got our headlight covers, the windows for each door. We've got our large piece of windshield glass, and you can see the workshop logo through there. So that should be nice and clear parts on there with their moldings in there for the little openings where they reach out, get their bottle of water and all that. We got our back glass. Everything molded and beautifully clear, the headlight covers and everything. Then on this side of the table, we've got that nice decal sheet printed in Italy. So I wonder if that means these are cartographed decals, but you can see the large white stripes and the black surrounds. Before the headlights are done, we'll just have to paint the buckets there. But other than that, that's all done for us with decals. We got the 23 emblems. We've even got seat belts for the interior. We've got Goodyear logos for the tires. It's hard to see that white on that background, but you can see the Goodyear logos for the tires in there and all other small sponsors. It's mainly sponsored by Porsche, so, and Shell. That's why you're not going to see a ton of stuff Goodyear on there, but we'll have some nice decals for those tires, which really helps out everything. Going on to the other side of the table, we've got parts molded in black styrene, which is a lot of the frame and brace parts, which is awesome because they're supposed to be black. Even this skinny, look how skinny some of those details are. And not having to paint these, because they would be a little bit of a shiny black, might help us during the assembly process of putting parts on later. Got our nice Momo steering wheel, got some hubs. Look at the little shocks on there and everything. Excellent detail. Inner fenders of the kit, molded in black. Precise detail, check out that suspension on there. Everything looks lovely, very well defined. Even the windshield wiper blades, all on there. Steering. I wonder if it's going to be posable steering because the tie rod here just snaps into place. We recognize those. So we'll have to see as we build it up. On the other black tree, we've got the wheels, which are black from the factory, but I think I'm going to get some paint on those. We've got our dashboard cover. We've got our firewall, which is actually behind the driver. Transmission, excellent detail on there. Top of the engine with exhaust. Or are those manifolds on that one? We'll find out. Beautiful looking four-wheel disc brakes. And the brakes, look, actually have a rough grooved texture molded into them. They wouldn't be vented in 1970. They hadn't started drilling stuff on a lot of things. On this one, they were solid. But that is, sorry, I don't mean to focus on a brake disc that long, but that is actually really nice molding. We got a little bit of a grill here. Look at those brakes again. No. So anyways, let's pull out some other plastic in the kit. We've got white styrene. On the top of that pile is the gorgeous Porsche Le Mans body for the 917. I just love these cars. They kept these, I mean, they even race designs very similar to this now. Molded open vents over the front wheels so that the body doesn't lift and take off. Nice panel line moldings. Naked ducts towards the back of the car. Even got the rings molded in it. Very nicely done. Moldings all the way around there. We'll have to paint the headlight buckets black, but you can even do that by hand if you didn't want to mask those off. That edge is sharp enough that you could paint that and then just take a Q-tip and get the paint off. So maybe we'll do it that way. Maybe we'll mask it off and spray it. Nice looking bodywork on the kit. And finally, the last large piece of styrene. Look at the underpan of that chassis with all the sensitive detail. Be careful not to break that when you're pulling it apart. Got our front suspension arms molded in. The nice smooth body down there. We've got the rear. Might even be the front with the ducts coming in. We've got various body parts, engine, cover, openings. We got our, looks like a driver's seat. Yeah, driver's seat there. Nicely done. Nicely done parts there. So I'm going to start assembling mine. We're pretty much one version in the box, and I'll be right back.
Thank you.
As you can see during the extended build process, the kit is not hard to put together. It just takes a little while. It is, you know, 119 parts, but it's a lot of small parts that require more fiddly work than anything. But so far, the car is going together absolutely beautifully, like I would expect from a more modern 1/24th scale kit. We got our wheels all set here. I did deviate from the instructions in some of the processes, so you can look through their gorgeous manual when you order yours from Model Roundup and decide how you want to paint your model, how you want to get that work done, and that will allow you to go through the sections and decide what parts you want to put on where and how you want to align things based on how you want to decorate your kit. Their manuals are always lovely in those Revell Germany kits, full color and everything with great color guides. Now, they want me to put those poly caps on the ends of the brakes, but what I did was I installed them in the wheels instead, where they will go. Then I can press them onto those studs and have the job done in the exact same manner without much fuss. So the wheels really won't do anything but get a coat of paint, and then we'll be done with those. The chassis here goes together. Look at that assembly. Yet even though that is small and quite fiddly looking, it goes together very easily, as you saw on camera, and lines itself up. Looks wonderful. That will attach in the back. The only reason I couldn't put this on right now is because I want to paint the engine separately from the car. We've got our engine cover and our seats. Those are both required to be red according to the manual. So I will get those with a darker color primer and then paint those up so that the red on the seat and the engine cover isn't an identical match to the race body. I want those to be just a little different. The inner fenders here that go in the back, I'm just going to paint those a flat black so that they don't blend in, or that they don't look too much like shiny plastic for me on there. We've got some chassis components here, which I'm just going to hit with some black paint and then attach them. I'll do some detail painting, and I'll take some creative license. I know this is a real race car, but I want to do some things to enhance the look of it when I work on my model. This here, the fan assembly, the top of the motor is supposed to be a gold color, so I glued that all together. And then the center hub of the fan, they want to be a black color, so we'll get that painted. We have to assemble even the dual windshield wiper on one arm. So I've got that. That was the most stressful part of the build. I used super glue on it. Now I'll paint it to cover up the cloudiness from the super glue. We've got our fire extinguisher, which will get a red tone. We've got what I think are coils on the side of the engine, which are supposed to be blue with a metallic strap. So those I left off so I can paint those separately. We've got this large brace here. These down tubes for what I'm assuming are our intake will be painted by hand with a gold-colored paint. Then we will attach our clear lenses after painting this area here silver. I will attach the clear lenses for the taillights on the race car. These little parts here, as you saw me build them, are our axles for the drive in the rear. Those will get painted up on their own, detailed, and then attached to the engine. I don't see these parts mentioned in the manual. They look like caps and stuff. They may not be used on this kit, but I'm just going to get them painted. So if I have to hand paint them and attach them later, I can. But I went over the manual twice, didn't see them. But as you go over the manual doing your final assemblies, a lot of times you'll come across parts that you miss. This here is the grill. It goes in the very front of the body. On the box art, it is black. On the instructions, it is not black. In the instructions, you see that grill right there underneath the number 23 and Shell and Porsche logos is like a red with a black wash, but I'm going to do mine in black because I like how it looks on the box art in black like that. I like that in the front. So that's how I'm going to do mine, regardless of how the prototype is. That part right there will push into the body. We've got our dashboard and part of our chassis. That's going to end up going inside there. Now we'll get to the body. I've got the rear body assembled. Look how nicely that goes together inside and out. That whole back piece is attached. There's not one seam when you attach it on there. It all lines up like it should. Don't cut these little nibs off. That's how it's going to go on to the back of the car. Don't cut these little nibs off. They go into the roof line. I've got this part here just so I can hang onto it while it's painted. Then I can snip it off and touch those minute parts up with a little red paint. Don't fill in that hole. There's no parts for it. The Nika ducts here are filled in. And then we've got underneath, that's going to go on the back. You can see the size of that. Looks like an awesome 1/24th scale LeMans slot car. I put the body on the top, just so you could see how well it's going to go together at the end. Just interlocks into the chassis like so. You can see our engine out the bottom. We'll be able to hand paint that and detail that in metallic tones. We got our brakes. Those large studs are what the wheels are going to fit onto when they slide in. So now we can paint our brakes and everything. Get those all set up. We'll remove the body by just gently pulling it apart. On the body, I put that hatch in, put the bonnet in. We don't need to remove that. You can leave it removable. It does have a seam around it. So you can leave it removable if you want to look inside at the pedals and all the mechanism down there. So we've got that glued on. This is a piece that glues on, as you saw in the build session. All just wonderful fits on a beautiful car. Then we've got the main chassis here. I will pull the engine and transmission out so we can see how that went together. With the rear suspension, I can detail those shocks after I metallicize the exhaust and everything and work that over. We'll give it all one metallic color and then I'll go in and hand detail it. This is everything that I glued together on the chassis. The driver's seat mount, the passenger seat will sit much lower. We got a equipment box there. We got some detail to do on the firewall, electronics. We got our pedals glued in because all this stuff's going to be covered except for being able to see the brakes from the side when the wheels aren't on it. So all it is set, we got our radiator and our cooling duct here. Inside of the body, everything lines up lovely. Rear brakes, I did glue on, and suspension like that. We'll get this all painted up. I will hand accent everything. I've got to mask the body along this line right there and paint that the same as the body color. You can just make out that line. So we'll get this painted. I will mask this. I will paint it my body color, then we'll go in and paint everything else my standard chassis color, make it nice and basic and cool looking. So that's it. A lot of stuff to build. Takes a little while, but it actually reduces down to a fair number of parts for final assemblies, which I'm going to start painting right now. Thank you.
Thank you.
I approach the final turn in my Porsche 917 build. One of the things left to do, of course, is put on all the sweet decals. And as you saw, I did not paint around the outside of the headlights because they do include that nice blackout on the decal sheet. So I'll be using that. But I did black out the inside of the headlights with black craft paint. Very easy to do. Then glued the light in. Then once that was dry, I glued the top piece of glass, the aerodynamic cover, and glued the windshield in. I did the frame of the windshield with black Sharpie marker, and it looks lovely. Got our windows or our door glass in place, and we got that nice red pepper Krylon paint looking awesome. We've got the windshield wiper left to install, and some small chrome parts left to glue on the body once we get all the decals down and everything like that. The inner fenders haven't gone on. I'll put them on in just a second here, but I wanted you to see what the chassis looks like without it, and it looks like the world's fastest go-kart. They should make them race like this. That'd be kind of cool. Got our ducts here, got our wheel on the back, got our engine cover and our fan out the top. Got the two seats in it. Someone explain, is that just because like a regulation thing? It must have two seats in it or what? We've got the actual driver's seat with seat belts, and we got this little fake seat right next to it. I decorated the firewall up with some colored Sharpies. Got our dashboard in. Got the decals on that dashboard all highlighted with the steering wheel. And then you can see underneath, I painted it the colors that they recommended. And then took some artistic license on some other things, but the exhaust, they say, should be all black with this gold surround. Then we've got these ducts coming in from the top. We got our tail lights in. It's all, you know, an extensive build. It's quite fiddly once you get to putting it in. Inside the wheels, you can see the brakes there. I will have pictures at the end with the wheels off so you can see the brake detail on there. But for now, I put them on there. The poly caps work just fine on the front. On the rear, it was much too tight of a fit, so I removed the poly caps and superglued the wheels on to the suspension and brake assembly back there. But that's looking tight. That looks really nice. We got our two-tone paint. We're going to put our fenders in. Our fenders will just go in like so and prop themselves up in the back. Then we will install our body. It's not really meant to have the body come off once it's all together because there's nothing to look at when the body's off. You can't see much of the engine and there's a big hole through it. So it's just an engine cover. You can see more from the bottom where they left it open to cool it and ease working on it. And the main body will of course attach like so and clip down tighter. Then I'll put my decals on, get it all glued up, and when I'm all done, I'll come back for that final. Now I've completed what I think is the first Le Mans car on the channel. I've had some opportunities for a GT40, but I haven't built one yet that I remember. So this would be my first Le Mans winning car, and it is a cool one. I think the only cars that I thought were better looking, or at least the color schemes of the Le Mans cars of this style, were the Nissans. Remember those back in the day? That blue and red scheme they always had. But anyways, this kit is awesome. Model Roundup has these in stock right now. It is a limited edition, so make sure you snatch it up if you want in this color scheme with those decals. Something I didn't know about the decals when I saw them on the decal sheet is, thankfully, these three long thin stripes going all the way back actually have clear carrier between them. So you don't have to try to line up those skinny, skinny decals. The 23 and the Porsche are their own decals, so you can line those up easy. But getting those decals that go all the way along the body to stay equally spaced isn't difficult at all because it's one large decal that lays down and then it's opened up for the headlights. So those went on real nice. I used a good amount of decal solvent because it is quite a complex curve. It's going down and over. It's also going around the tops of the fenders. Each stripe bends around the fender and it has to mold around the multiple compound curves of the headlights. So I did use a strong decal solvent, plus I cut them free inside the fender vents here to let air out of the fenders, and I made sure to use decal solvent in there so it's soaked in. They go on easily. There's only one thing I notice is that the number 23, the round roll on the back here and on the sides, are somewhat transparent, so on those I can still see the white stripes, so you might want to cut those. Where you see that circle back there, you may want to cut that decal and remove those white stripes because you can kind of see them. Otherwise, they all laid down beautifully. The only part of the kit, that I was dissatisfied with personally was the windshield wiper assembly. That is really hard to get both of those blades on there and have it sit on the glass. I had to rework that quite a few times to actually get it to look realistic on the, otherwise, everything went together. Look how well that three-piece body, the bottom, the front, and the back sit. I mean, there's supposed to be a big seam right there, and it looks just like it would on the real thing. Super small, and along the bottom, there are small pins that just push into place. I super glued them on there. I did have to trim the top of the inner fenders in the back and some of the radiator in the front with a file and a little bit of snippers. Had to trim that to get everything to sit perfectly, and those are parts that you will never see again once you assemble this model. So go ahead and if you need to, shave those down a little bit to get everything to sit well and sit level. Won't make a difference at all. Everything locks together beautifully. The kit looks awesome from underneath, and it was a pleasure to build. I was a little intimidated, thought it might not go together because these things are quite delicate. You know, you've got all this assembly in the back here, all those rods and stuff holding things up, but nope, this kit went together super, super easily. I thank modelroundup.com for sending this over. I will link in the description where you can snag yours. I just love these cars, so I hope to see Revell Germany reissue some of the Nissan racers. I would definitely get one to put next to this one on display so that you could check it out. I'm gonna have some pictures, of course, of the full build, even the car without any decals on it. If you wanted to get some custom decals for it, you can see what it looks like, and some interior shots of the bodywork not on the model at the end of this video. Build your kits for you, have fun, build the subjects you like, and we'll see all of you at the next review.